Hi there! Welcome back to Let's Play Alex Kidd in the Enchanted Castle. This is the Pyramids, and this is the first level to have a boss. Now, the bosses in this game are really the most annoying part. Rather than fighting a boss, instead, you play a game of rock, paper, scissors against them. And unlike when you play rock, paper, scissors against the shopkeepers, if you lose, you actually lose a life. And I'm not sure how I'm going to handle that for the videos, because that could potentially be really dull and repetitive, playing rock, paper, scissors over and over again until I win, because you only have a 1 in 3 chance of winning. Okay, I said we got every item in the game last time. I was lying. We didn't have the necklace. What the necklace does is, if you equip it, which I'll go ahead and do now, then it allows you to read somebody's mind if you're playing rock, paper, scissors against them. Now, you think that would make the bosses incredibly easy. However, unless you have split-second timing, it really doesn't seem to help that much. Because the bosses can always just change their move at the last possible minute. And if you don't match them with the correct thing, then you're boned. I'm not sure how helpful it's going to be for fighting the bosses. I'm going to try not to screw this up. And like the cape and the stick, the necklace goes away after you use it, so if you do lose, then when you play again, it's completely just nothing but luck. Should be coming up on the boss pretty soon. Yep, there she is. She's the queen of the oasis. You must defeat her to pass. Okay, you can't push a button to end the game prematurely against the bosses. You just have to wait until the music stops. And as you can see what her move is going to be over in the bubble there. And I'm going to try my damnedest to make sure I don't screw this up. There we go. Okay, she's going to ask you to play again. You don't have to say yes, you can say no. A lot of people probably say yes because, you know, they assume that the game's gonna kill you if you say no, but you don't have to give her another chance. And I'm not going to because I'm a cruel bastard like that. And this is Hi-Ho Forest. We have a bunch of little Wanpaku graffiti-style lumberjacks running around. Some of these trees are solid, and you can destroy them. Some of them are transparent, and you can walk through them. And the lumberjack can throw pieces of wood at you. Oops. Okay, that chest is actually really annoying to try to get to, because that block over to the right falls away as soon as you step on it. I'm going to give it the old college try. It's another necklace there. Oh, and we lost it. Actually, I did that the stupid way. I could have just jumped into it from the left, but I forgot. Oh well. Maybe I'll die and get another chance. I'm not sure why it gives you a necklace in this level. I don't think there's a boss here. I don't know, maybe there is. Yeah, there's only one boss that you actually fight, and that's the last boss of the game. And you fight him after playing rock, paper, scissors with him. Yeah, I really don't like the bosses very much at all. I think that was sort of a cheap cop-out on their part. Rock, paper, scissors is kind of a dumb gimmick anyway. Let's see if we can go further down. No. Personally, I prefer odds and evens to rock, paper, scissors. It's a similar game, but there's no chance of getting ties. What you do is, you make fists like you're getting ready to play rock, paper, scissors. Oh shit. Only instead of saying, you know, well, you still say the same thing. You're just like, 1, 2, 3, go, or 1, 2, 3, or however you do it. Well, beforehand, one person picks either odds or evens. That's the important part of this. Oh, I guess there is a boss in this level. And it's a fat, ugly, middle-aged, balding, bear-looking dude. And since I don't have a necklace, I guess I will attempt to go into this blind. I'll unequip my ring, just in case I lose, because I don't want to lose the ring. Trip ends here. And I have no clue what to throw. I'm just going to pick something and hope for the best. Alright! Man, I've been really lucky with rock, paper, scissors lately. Anyway, one person chooses odds or evens, and then you each throw a certain amount of fingers, and if the number of fingers equals what the person said, then they win, otherwise the other person wins, blah blah blah. It's easy enough to figure out. Oh, that's only been about 6 minutes so far. I'm not sure if we have time to... Oh look, it's Tropics Town. AKA Blatant Recycling Town. Recycling of graphics. It looks exactly like Rookie Town. I don't know if there's anything in these huts that I want. Another pogo stick? No. This is probably bonds, but I'll try it anyway. Another motorcycle, not really useful. I don't really want that. I don't know, the motorcycle might be useful on this level. Seems kind of flat. Okay, done. I don't know what I'm looking for, except maybe another necklace. I guess that's the only thing I really need. I guess it couldn't hurt to have a spare. Once again, I don't know what we're seeing sees, so I'm just trying whatever. Yeah, I get it. I lose. Oops. Come on. Throw paper. Come on. Yes. I knew I'd wear you down eventually. Okay, so now we have a backup in case we die, which hopefully isn't going to happen, but you never know. It might. I might run up against a boss that just completely screws me. Alright, and this is a really short level. That does it for Tropics Town. I'll go on ahead and end the video here. Tune in next time for Rock Mountain 1. I'm Duke of the Bump. See you guys later.